So today we're going to register a domain name. And when we think of a domain name, that's what we most associate when we think of a website. For example, this is Google. The actual domain name is google.com. Domain name is the .com, .org, .net, or whatever it is that you type into the browser address bar to get to the information, the website that you want to go to. Computers speak to each other using numbers and dots and all sorts of things that are very hard for us to remember. But to make things simple for us, we use words. So I'm going to Dynadot.com is where I'm going to register from. You could use many different domain registrars. There's GoDaddy, there's UniRegistrar, there's literally hundreds of them. For the most part, they do the same thing. It's a commodity. But the reason why I use Dynadot.com is because, one, they are cheap, and two, they offer a lot of things for free that other registrars such as GoDaddy charge for. The hardest part about picking a domain or registering a domain is finding one that is short that is not taken. So I want JOL.com, but this already taken. So today I'm going to register getjol.com. Right here, you can see it's $6.99 for the first year. Then it's going to renew at $8.99. So I'm going to add that to my cart. And right here, you see domain privacy. Domain privacy is it hides your information, because when we register, we put in our name, our address, our email address, phone number, and all that stuff. So marketers and different companies can't look that information up. You need a private registration, and Dynadot.com offers that for free. GoDaddy, which is the number one registrar, they will charge for that. So depending on the registrar, you could charge anywhere between $7 and $14 for that. With Dynadot, it comes free. And the registrars that I typically use, that is a free service that they offer. But Dynadot right now is my favorite one that I'm currently using. And you type in your information here. So where did you hear this from? YouTube. You type in the captcha to let them know that you're a real person, not a computer. Type in your payment information, your card, everything right here. Just put that in. For zip code, just put your parish. And you can use PayPal, Skrill, or other payments. But I'm just using cards, so I will submit order. And right there you go. It is registered. All your information shows up on the bottom, your username, your phone number, etc. So the last step that you're going to do is you're going to your email box, the email that you use to sign up for that, because you have to confirm this. Right now, you can see you have 15 days to click on this link right here. And what that does is it lets the ICANN, which is the body that oversees all domains, lets them know that you put in real information and it's an active email address, and you are confirming that all the information you put in there is your legal, real information. And you're clicking that right there within 15 days. That way you can keep your domain. And just remember that it's going to renew annually. You know, it's not like you buy this thing one time and you own it forever. No, what you're going to do, it's each year you're paying for it. It's sort of like taxes, but for what it is, $8.99, $6.99, whatever it is, even if it's $20, it's well worth it. And considering what it is, it's just a nominal cost. If you look at the link in the description below, you can see the link to Dynadot.com where you can register your domain. And also, you will see a resource where you can search multiple domain names at the same time. So that way you can figure out if your name is taken. Let's say you want goodmusic.com, but goodmusic.com is already taken, and you want to know if a .co, .net, or something else is available. You just type that in there, and you know, good music, and it shows you everything that is available. So hopefully I covered everything. I was trying to move quickly, but if you have any other questions that I did not cover, feel free to ask in the comments, and I will respond.